Welcome. Subscribe to AS Foundation, India's leading academy for CA course, and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Thank you.
Okay, please come to this example. Very simple example. XYZ purchased 80% share of ABC on 1st April 2001 for 1,40,000. Underline 1st April 2001. The issued capital of ABC Limited on 1st April 2001 was 1 lakh and the balance in the statement of profit and loss was 60,000. So that is on the date of acquisition, share capital and P&L account they are talking about. Then for the year ending 31st March 2002, 1 year is over. What happened? ABC earned a profit of rupees 20,000 and at the same time declared and paid a dividend of rupees 30,000. So profit earned 20,000 but dividend paid is how much? 30,000. Assume the fair value of NCI is the same as the fair value on a per share basis of the purchased interest. Now what is this paragraph? Fair value of NCI is same as fair value on a per share basis of the purchased interest. Now see, for 80% share, parent paid 1,40,000. Then this says fair value of NCI is same as fair value on a per share basis of the purchased interest. So from this line, you have to find the fair value of NCI. 1,40,000 divided by 80% into 20%. How much it comes to? Yes, so indirectly it means the NCI fair value is 35,000. Using the amount paid by parent, you can find out the NCI value. That is the meaning of this sentence. So 35,000 is NCI on the date of acquisition. 35,000 is NCI on the date of acquisition. 1,40,000 divided by 80% into 20%. And what is the net identifiable asset? Net identifiable asset is 1,75,000. How much is printed in your book? 1,75,000. Show by an entry. By an entry, how the dividend should be recorded in the books of XYZ Limited. Dividend will be 30,000 into 80%. How much will that be equal to? 24,000. Now we don't have to worry about pre-acquisition and post-acquisition. Just for your information, the old material of ICAI, when they had issued, that time they had considered pre-acquisition and post-acquisition. But then they have revised the chapter. Now in the new chapter, they have rectified that. Is it right? So student with old material will find the answer printed in the study material is different. And the student with new study material will find the answer is different. So we'll go by the new answer now, which is right. So what entry they will record for dividend received? So first calculate the dividend. It's printed there in your notes. 30,000 into, type there 80%. Write there 80%. You also have to participate. So that is equal to, and then the entry bank account debit 24,000 to profit and loss account 24,000. No need to divide this between P&L account and investment. no need to check that out of 30, 20 is out of current year and 10 is out of previous year. Those happy days are gone. In fact, new happy days has come now, because that problem will not be there now. In AS21, that was a continuous tension in problem of dividend. Okay. Now the entry will be same irrespective of the source bank to P&L account. What is the next question? I forgot to read the full question. Up to this we have read, and up to this we have solved. Next is, what is the amount of NCI on 1st April 2021? 35,000 and 31st March 20X2 after 1 year using fair value method. Also pass a journal entry on acquisition date. They are giving random questions, okay? First they are asking you pass entry for dividend. So the sequence of the question is, it should come at the end. First they should ask this question, pass journal entry on acquisition. Then calculate NCI on acquisition, calculate NCI at the end, pass entry for dividend. Okay, just like they pass the students randomly, they've asked this question also randomly. So my next task will be calculation of NCI on the date of acquisition. That is printed somewhere in your notes. 1,40,000 divide by 80% gives me total value of 100% share of subsidiary, whereas NCI share is 20%. So I will take 20% of 1,75,000, that comes to 35,000. Printed, tick mark. Is it there? Coincidentally, in this question, the net identifiable asset is also 1,75,000, but don't use that figure for calculation. As per the instruction, you have to take fair value. Coincidentally, fair value of the 100% share and the fair value of net asset, both are 1,75,000. So therefore, any method you choose in this question, the answer is 35,000. Next, we will pass journal entry on the date of acquisition. In your notes, you have to revise the answer. Check. Identifiable net asset account debit 1,75,000. But in your notes somewhere it is 150 is written. If a wrong answer is printed, rectify. Student will get totally confused. In the question 175, in the answer of the institute 150, for 2 days I was wondering how the difference has come. Then I realized, no, the answer is wrong. To cash paid 140, to NCI 35,000. There is no goodwill in this problem, because the fair value of the business and the fair value of the net asset are equal. So there is no goodwill in this question. Maybe in the question they wanted to write 1,50,000, but they printed 1,75,000. I don't know. Now the next question is, what is closing NCI? What is closing NCI? So take opening NCI and plus share of NCI in the current year profit. In the current year profit. So how much is the current year profit? See the last paragraph. 20,000. So just check the answer. 35 plus current year profit 20,000. And NCI share is 20%. When we'll prepare the balance sheet, we'll do the same exercise. 39,000. Okay, into bracket, right? Before paying dividend. Before paying dividend. Before paying dividend. Anyway, now we'll take a 10 mark question. Number 7. So we'll solve few questions for practice. which will cover whatever we have discussed till now. Then again we will learn some more new concept. Again we'll take few questions, okay? So are you there with question number 7? But it is towards the end. Towards the end you will find there are total many questions printed, one below the other. And there is a question 7, Jack Company acquired. Towards the end of this, Jack Company. Additional question number 7. Jack acquired 100% share in stock company. Which date? 1st July. Underline. Now, henceforth, I will not tell you. Underline the date of acquisition. And the problem will become little serious if the date of acquisition is somewhere middle of the year, during the year, because then my calculation of profit will be done proportionately. Some adjustments like depreciation, profit calculation will be done proportionately. So be careful. Okay. This is a special topic for you. It carries huge weightage in the exam. So understand everything carefully. Date of acquisition is 1st July 15. And the balance sheet date of Jack and its subsidiary is 31st December 15. So what is the date of consolidation here? Date of consolidation, 31st December 15. So that means post acquisition period covers how many months? 6 months. Post acquisition period covers 6 months only. Next line, assets, non-current asset, tangible investment, investment in shares of stock company, loan stock of stock company. This loan word you write in the next line. Loan stock of stock company, 10,000. So it seems Jack has given loan to stock 10,000 rupees, tick mark. We will eliminate it. Then next line, current asset, inventory, receivable, bank, total, equity and liabilities, capital and reserves, shares, retained earning, non-current liabilities, loan stock, tick, tick. So if you see, asset side, loan stock of stock company 10,000 and liability side, stock company's balance sheet shows loan stock 10,000. Matching, tick mark, and don't write both the item in the balance sheet. It is matching exactly 10,000 and 10,000. Overdraft payable total. Additional information. Receivable in Jack include rupees 8,000 receivable from stock. Now you tick mark receivable. How much is receivable? 8,000. Intercompany receivable. And payable in stock company includes 5,500. Oh, there is a problem. If I remove 8,000 and 5,500, your balance sheet will not tally. Next line, the balance in retained earning on the date of acquisition was 4,000. See the status of retained earning of stock company. On the date of acquisition, it was 4,000. And now in the balance sheet, retained earning is how much? 16,000. So that means how much amount got added in the post-acquisition period? 12,000. And this 12,000 I will distribute to parent and NCI. Is it right? Prepare a consolidated statement of financial position of the group for their ended 31st December 2015. What is the meaning of statement of financial position? Balance sheet. But this question has not yet told me why this difference is coming. So then the student has to write an assumption. The difference is check in transit or goods in transit. So what is better? Check in transit, because in goods in transit again unrealized profit issue may turn up. deferred tax adjustment may come up. So to be on a safer side, you assume one party might have issued the check, but other have not received. Okay. So what is the adjustment I am going to do on the asset side? I will minus 8,000 from receivable and I will add, how much is that? 2,000 in cash equivalent. So my effect on the asset side will be 5,500. And on the liability side, I will deduct 5,500. So this way, the net effect on both the sides will be 5,500. Reduce receivable by 8,000. Simultaneously increase cash and cash equivalent by 2,500 because that is check in transit, and reduce the trade payable by 5,500. So this adjustment is a new adjustment. Loan you will cancel, and this time there is a post acquisition profit of the subsidiary. In the earlier three balance sheet we prepared, one yesterday and two today, all the questions were same in terms of date of acquisition and date of consolidation. Okay. So first what we will do, formats. Very easy problem. But slowly and slowly the problems will become more and more difficult. Don't worry. We'll start with easy ones. So I will give you the format. Copy the format. You can always write yourself also if you want. More or less the format is given in the question, which can be used in the exam with some improvement. Okay. So write down CBS of Jack Company Limited as on 31-12-2015. Draw this format. Right hand side rupees. Point number A, assets. Then you write under that one, non-current asset. Good handwriting. Property, plant and equipment. Intangible asset. Dash goodwill. Point number two, write current asset. Point number two, numbering system follow. Under current asset, write down small a inventories, small b financial assets. Under financial assets, trade receivable, cash and cash equivalent. One line blank again. Part B right on the screen. Equity and liabilities. One equity. Under equity A, share capital. B, other equity. One line blank, point two. NCI will also be there or no? 100%. Then who asked me to write NCI also? You. Somebody said NCI. You write, keep it zero. Suppose in the exam you are not sure, you can draw the format with NCI also. It will remain zero. Point number two, write current liabilities. Then you should ask why I am not writing non-current liability, which is there in the balance sheet. That will be eliminated. Okay. Then write current liabilities. Under that, financial liabilities under that 2 points, bank overdraft, trade payable, total equity and liabilities, total equity and liabilities, total equity and liabilities. After that we will write, close that balance sheet, consolidated statement of changes in equity. Consolidated statement of changes in equity. Keeping the question in mind, draw the format. So in this question we will have share capital, retained earning, total, non-controlling interest, you can write NCI, okay, group means final total, just two lines, opening balance. NCI you may ignore, actually there is no NCI. Why I have written? Don't write NCI, only three columns, share capital, retained earning, total. Maybe copy paste, okay, format. Opening balance is there, and in this question you have to also add post acquisition profit of subsidiary. For 6 months they have earned some post acquisition profit, that I will directly add here, okay. Please do not write the last two columns, and if you have written, don't cut it, let it be. Next, write down working notes. Working note 1, calculation of goodwill. Draw this format for goodwill. We don't have NCI, so I have just directly written point A, consideration paid, and compared with the net asset. Have they given you fair value of any asset or liability on the date of acquisition? No, which means book value is equal to fair value, which means net asset on the date of acquisition is equal to share capital plus pre-acquisition profit, okay. And if suppose they give you that fair value of the PP was higher by 10,000, I will add one more line here, fair value adjustment. Is it right? We'll do that in next problem, don't worry. This is oversimplified question. There is no NCI, there is no fair value adjustment, no action. So tell me, anybody, what is goodwill or capital reserve? Anybody wants to try his luck? Goodwill, 1,000. Sure. Let me check. Oh, you are right. So write down there, consideration paid. Check in the balance sheet, where is consideration paid? Asset side, investment in shares of stock company 30,000. Can you see that? And net asset represented by share capital. Can you see 25,000 share capital? And how much was the pre-acquisition profit on the date of acquisition? 4,000. Somewhere in the note number 2 below. Right, given total B 29,000, point C goodwill, don't write capital reserve, or if you have written, just cancel it, okay. Smooth cancel, not like this. So now, are you ready to solve? This is very simple question. Nothing much to be adjusted here. So kindly participate and give me the answer. First point, net non-current asset PPE. Tangible asset means PPE. Tell me the total. 68,000 plus 42,000, 1,10,000. Goodwill, 1,000. Current asset inventory, 14,000 plus 12,500, 26. No adjustment. Trade receivable has an adjustment, 20,000 plus 15,000 minus 8,000 receivable from other company. How much is that? 20. Cash and cash equivalent also has an adjustment. That is your 6,000 plus 0 and plus 2,500, right? RIT. Right to info. RIT means remittance in transit. Okay. So how much is that? 8,500. Anybody wants to answer current asset total? 60? Okay, don't write total now. We'll write it later. First, we'll check whether they're tallying or not, okay? Then we'll come to equity share capital. For these two things, I will go to SOCIE. Kindly come to SOCIE. Opening balance of only parent company, write down. Share capital. You'll find 85,000 there. And retained earning of parent, write down full amount. 44. Because we don't know how much was current year and how much was opening balance. They're not given us. Parent breakup is not available. And what about the total of these two figure? 129,750. Post acquisition subsidiary. Post acquisition profit of subsidiary. We will add to parents' profit. To parents' profit. Is it right? How much is subsidiary's post acquisition profit? Right, 12,000. How this 12,000 has come? Those who want to write. 16 minus 4. So tell me the total of all three columns again. 85,000. This is 5,6,7,50. And this is how much? 141. Yes. Now this figure you transfer to balance sheet share capital, and this figure you transfer to retained earning in the balance sheet. So come back to balance sheet. You write share capital 85,000 in the first column, and write 56,750 in the second first column. Total in the outer column. How much is that? 141. So this will help the investor to immediately understand this company's equity is 141,750. If you can write in the inner column, then outer column, it is good. In the exam, you don't have so much time. So write directly in the outer column. If you have time, then write in the inner column. Now what about bank overdraft? Is there only one figure? Read directly here. Trade payable 18,250 plus 10,500. 18,250 plus 10,500 and minus also 5,500. Haji. 23,250. Again, try to take total in the outer column separately for current liabilities. The purpose of presentation is that people should know what is current liability in one snapshot, okay? He should not sit with the calculator and see what is the current liability of this company. So what is the total of this side? 173,000. Asset side. Same. Amazing. 173,000. 173,000. Assumption right. It is assumed that at the end of the answer. All notes assumptions at the end of the answer. It is assumed that the difference in payable and receivable, it is assumed that difference in payable and receivable is represented by remittance in transit, is represented by remittance in transit. Okay, everything we have written. Now we'll go to next question, number 8. One more question we'll solve quickly. Come on, keep question number 8 in front of you. Question number 8. Rose Company acquired shares in Lotus Company. Okay, on 1/10/15, underline 1/10/15. So what is the date of acquisition? This time 1/10/15. Date of acquisition. And what is the balance sheet of Rose and Lotus on 31/12/15? 31/12/15. Okay, that is date of consolidation. So how many months are there between these two dates? There are 3 months. So my calculation for profit, if required, we have to change accordingly. Depreciation will get affected, etc. So sometime it is important for solving the problem, the time period. Ready? Balance sheet is almost same like previous problem. Tangible asset, investment in ordinary shares of Lotus, tick mark loan stock of Lotus. This will eliminate. Now see, on the liability side, if you see liability side, non-current liability, loan stock is 12,000. They have changed the question. Asset side 10, liability side 12. Now it's not written that loan stock is entirely related to Rose. It can be 2000 from others. 2000 from, so that loan from other party will appear in the balance sheet. Only cancel 10 10, and 2000 you just continue to show in the balance sheet. It might relate to some other third party. So this is the small change they have done in the question. Okay, don't cancel both and write on the liability side remittance in transit. Do we write remittance in transit on the liability side? Is it my liability or asset? Asset. Okay. Next, current asset, inventory, receivable, bank, total. Capital and reserve. Ordinary shares. Then reserve. Non-current liabilities. Loan stock, tick mark. So if there is a tick mark, means there is an adjustment. So we'll have to write the adjusted figure in the final answer. Payable, total liability, again same adjustment. The receivable of rupees 10,000 of Rose is from Lotus. Payable in Lotus Company include 6,500 to Rose. Same treatment. 10,000 reduced from receivable. Tick mark receivable. Tick mark payable. Tick mark cash at bank. 10,000 reduced from receivable, 6,500 reduced from payable, add 3,500 rupees in cash and cash equivalent. Okay. Do I need to explain again? Same thing. Balance in reserve on the date of acquisition is 22,000. So on the date of acquisition, the reserve position is 22. So what is my post-acquisition change in reserve. Go to balance sheet, search for reserve of subsidiary. Is it 25,000? Here. So the change is how much? 3,000. 3,000 was earned post-acquisition. And in this question, what is the percentage of stake held by parent company? 75%. Then in the note below, they have written, Rose company bought ordinary share with a par value of 30,000 for rupees 50,000. So that will give me percentage of share held by Rose. 30,000. What is the share capital of the subsidiary? 40,000. In this question, it is 75%. And to help you, they have mentioned below also NCI 25% fair value was 18,000. So in this question, this post acquisition profit of subsidiary will be apportioned between NCI and parent. 25-75. Okay. That is another change in the problem. This question has NCI also. And in this question, the loan figures are not equal. These are the two changes they have done in the problem. The remaining question was same. Prepare consolidated balance sheet for the group. So first we will draw balance sheet format. Then SOCIE. Then working note 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever number of working notes required. Are you ready for the show? Come on. Right. In the question, they may give you tangible asset. But you will write the heading PPE. Is it right? Question may give you wordings like fixed asset, tangible asset. Student will have to write in the answer PPE. Property, plant and equipment. Come on, fast. Non-current asset, PPE. Write PPE. Then next line, intangible asset. Dash goodwill. If you get goodwill, write. Otherwise, write zero. Don't worry. Point two, write current asset. Numbering system. Point two, current asset, small a, inventories, small b, financial asset. Under financial asset, trade receivable, cash and cash equivalent, total, one line blank. Then write down part B, point B, one line blank, then write point B, equity and liabilities, good handwriting. Under that write equity. Under equity write share capital. Other equity. NCI, now this time NCI is there. Point two, non-current liabilities. Under that, financial liabilities. Under that, loan. Point three, current liabilities. Point three, current liabilities. Under that, trade payable. One line blank, total. Close that balance sheet format. Close that balance sheet format. Then we'll write down consolidated SOCIE. Consolidated SOCIE. Same format, but this time two more columns on the right side, NCI and group also. Start writing. Bring a scale because number of columns will go up in some questions. if you write neatly, it becomes very quick to revise a day before the exam. Okay. First, write down A, opening balance, B, fair value of NCI on the date of acquisition, C, add share in post acquisition profit, add share in post acquisition profit, total then I will this time prepare three working note 1, shareholding percentage. Again, if we don't have time in the exam, you can avoid this if it is very obvious. So write down shareholding percentage. Under that, write down shareholding percentage in which company, whose shareholding we are analyzing. Lotus. In Lotus company, there are two shareholders, Rose Limited 75% and NCI 25%. Agreed? 35 75 25. Working note 2, analysis of profit. Whose profit we are analyzing? Lotus. So every time you will write in working note 1 and 2 the name of the subsidiary. Every time I may or may not write, you will write. Keep some 10 lines blank here, around 10 to 12 lines blank. If more lines are required, I will tell you. Okay. And then working note 3, this format we will follow generally, but sometime we will add that fair value adjustment also here if required. Okay. Action. Draw the format of goodwill also. Keep it ready. Questions will become little difficult as we'll go ahead. Then adjustment on unrealized profit on stock, fixed asset, dividend, impairment of goodwill. Okay. Fair value adjustment will come. So far in none of this question we have taken fair value of asset and liabilities. We have taken simply the same book values. Format is ready. Now this time what I'll do, we will go line by line as per the question. Okay, and we'll do adjustments at the end by giving the twofold effect. When we'll do the adjustment, anything from outside the balance sheet, if I do any adjustment, we'll have to give the second effect also. Understood? And then at the end it will tally. So start. Property, plant, equipment. Do we have any adjustment here? No. So take 75,000 plus 60, 50, 3,000. So how much is that? 1,28,000. Goodwill will do later. Inventory. No, wait. In your question, investment is appearing 50,000. We'll go by the question sequence. You will not miss anything. Where will you write that investment? That is the consideration paid. So it will be written here. 50,000. Okay. Come back. Loan stock of Lotus. Cancel. Inventory. Check whether any adjustment is there. No. Just add 15,000, 12,500. Total is how much? 27,500. Trade receivable has an adjustment. 20,000. Come to adjustment number 1. We'll do it now only to save time. And how much is receivable of Rose Company? Include 10,000 receivable from Lotus. Can I reduce 10,000 here? Say yes. How much is that? 30,000. Cash and cash equivalent. What is cash of Rose Company? Plus cash in transit 3500 RIT. Remittance in transit. How much is that? 15,500. So how much is this total coming up to? Okay, don't take total, goodwill is pending. This way we will not miss anything. Now total asset, equity and liability, share capital and reserve. First come to SOCIE. Share capital of parent company, 1,15,000. Reserve of parent company, 44,750. Wait a minute. Share capital of 40,000 subsidiary, where will you write? Here. In calculation of goodwill working note, 40,000. That figure is used. And what about the reserve of subsidiary? Reserve of subsidiary in analysis of profit. So you write here total reserve as per balance sheet. Total reserve as per balance sheet, is it 25,000? Now there is an adjustment number 2 less pre-acquisition reserve, 22,000. So immediately I will remove it from here and I will shift it here. Pre-acquisition reserve you will remove from working note 2 and shift in working note 3. Correct? So what is left now? What will you call it? Yes. Post-acquisition reserve. So reserve adjustment done. 22 here, 3 here. We'll come back to this working note. Next is loan. Loan stock will come in balance sheet. How much? 2,000. Working write down 12,000 minus 10,000 intercompany. Outer column 2,000. Okay. Next line, payable. Now there is an adjustment. 18,250 plus 12,500. And how much is intercompany dues? 6,500. 24,250. All items in balance sheet we have to first ensure we have done. Then adjustment number 1, done. 2, done. 3, done. 4, not done. What is 4? NCI. So I have to put NCI at two places. First, fair value of NCI on the date of acquisition here, 18,000. Okay. And we will also write this fair value of NCI, second effect, in goodwill working note here, 18,000. Okay. Now you can close goodwill. First you take total of A and B. A plus B, 68. D1 plus D2, 62. So what is goodwill? Cut, cancel capitalism of 6,000. Where will you transfer this 6,000? Balance sheet, asset side, goodwill, 6,000. And now there is a small adjustment pending. This 3,000 rupees we will divide between ROS and NCI in the ratio of working note 1, shareholding percentage. Can you see this? I have computed for this purpose only. 2250 and 750. 2250, 750. So where will you post this now? SOCIE. There is a third line here. Share in post acquisition profit. Parent share you will add in retained earning. NCI share you will add in NCI. Is it right? Parent NCI. Now first I'll complete this line first. Each line I will need to complete. 1,15,000 plus 44,750. 159,750. After ensuring that all lines are complete, now you complete columns. Take this total. 1,15,000. Take this total. Take this total. Next one. 1,60,000. Okay. 18,750. And last one, 180. Very good. This, and this. Transfer to balance sheet. Go to balance sheet, liability side. Right. Share capital. How much? Other equity, retained earning. 47,000. 18. This total you write in outer column. 1,00,000. Yes. So you get owner's equity, you get NCI, you get non-current liability, you get current liability. Now tell me the total. Asset side total. Asset side is also 2,07,000. Wow. Check the answer. The answer should flow smoothly. Items in balance sheet, one effect. Adjustment, double effect. Okay, only that basic adjustment you have to handle. 80% of the task is just mechanical format, working note format, putting the same number in different places. Your skill lies in just doing those few adjustments given in the problem. Okay, now we will continue tomorrow.